Hello students, welcome to lecture of kinematics and theory of machine. Myself Shailesh Patel, and we are going to discuss today the clutch. So we will discuss the types of friction clutch and the working and construction of that. Okay, let's start. So first of all, as you know that the clutch is a device used in a transmission system to connect and disconnect the two shaft as our requirement. Clutch is located between the engine and transmission system. Okay, when the clutch is engaged, power transmitted from the engine to the driving wheels through the transmission system. But when we need to change the gear, okay, what we will do, we apply the force on that clutch and it will disengage, and during that we can change the gear. Okay, and the RPM will be changed, and when we release the clutch pedal, it will engage, and the power from the engine will transmit to the driving wheel. Okay, so as you can see, the three types of friction clutches are there basically. So first is a single plate clutch, second is a multi plate clutch, and then centrifugal clutch. Okay, these are the friction based clutch, and also we will discuss the centrifugal clutch also. Okay, so you can see the flat plate friction clutch here. So check this. This is the driving shaft is here. Okay, the torque transmitted by that is a T. And you can see there is a driven shaft. Between them there is a pressure plates are there, and there is a springs is also there. Okay, spring are required to engage and disengage pressure plates. Okay, so W load, axial thrust, is you can see on the right now they are disengaged. Okay. Okay, you can see the flat plate friction clutch. You can see the driving shaft is here. Okay, and you can see the driven shaft is here. The two side by plates are known as a friction plates. Okay, spring you can see here, and between them there is a friction plate is there on a both side. Friction lining is there. Okay. Right now you can see the disengaged position is there, so the driving and driven is not connected right now, because we have used that force, we have applied the force in a clutch pedal, and that's why these both are disengaged. Okay, what will happen when we remove that force? Due to this spring force, these pressure plate will engage with this friction plate and this pressure plate also, and that's why due to the friction between them they will transmit the motion from the driving shaft to the driven shaft. When we applied the force on a pedal, we applied the force higher than this spring, and we remove this contact between these plates. Okay, this is the flat plate friction clutches. Okay, and the formula will be same here as the friction bearing. Okay, and there is also two criteria is there. One is a uniform wear theory and uniform pressure theory. If the clutch is new, then we can apply the uniform pressure theory, but after the time, the wear, due to wear, we have to apply the uniform wear theory. Okay, but if you want to transmit the more torque, we have to use the multi-plate clutch, and the surface of this friction will be higher, and you can see here the number of driving pair is a 6. Okay, so multi-plate clutch is used to transmit the higher torque. Okay, this is a multi-plate clutch. The working and construction will be similar to single-plate clutch. Only the number of plates will be higher. Okay? Then you can see the conclave here. In conclave, the surface which will be come in a contact at some angle, con angle, you can see the alpha is a semi-apex angle of that con. So, the torque transmitted will be change here, the mu w r into cosec alpha. When the surface is a flat vertical, the formula is only mu w r, where the r is a radius, effective radius. But in this case, in conical clutch, the formula is mu w r into cosec alpha, and alpha is a semi-apex angle of that cone. Okay, so let's check this. In this also similar to the single plate clutch, the spring is there which force the two plates toward the each other. So the friction should be friction between them is sufficient to transmit the torque. Okay. Now third and last is a centrifugal clutch. When this driving shaft is rotating, what will happen? This mass, which is at some distance r, they will rotate. And the as the RPM of driving shaft increase, the mass is rotating at some radius. Due to that, the centrifugal force will be increased. And it will come in a contact with this outer drum. This will come in contact with the outer drum, and this friction lining, friction between this friction lining, you can see on the outer side of that slot, it will come in a contact with the drum, and the friction will come in a case. And as the RPM increase, as the centrifugal force increase, you can see mu friction force is equal to mr omega square. Omega is nothing but angular velocity. As the RPM increase, what will happen? This surface will come in a contact with the outer surface and friction will be higher. After some point, what will happen? They will start rotating together. Okay, so that's why in a gearless vehicle, this type of clutch is used, where the as you increase the RPM, the centrifugal force will increase, and this lining or this surface will come in a contact with the drum, and at some point they will rotate. Only they sliding with each other, but after increase in RPM up to some point, after that the friction is sufficient to moving together with this whole drum, and the driven shaft will rotate together. Okay, thank you.